can see. So YouTube will be signed in. So if you know anybody who's watching via YouTube, tell them it'll be available.
Dexter's on YouTube, Lexi. Okay,
let me do YouTube over here on this one here, Kaylee.
Yeah, YouTube, I'm setting it up right now.
But on YouTube, you can't hear anything.
No, and on YouTube, they'll be able to hear. They just can't speak. So we can't hear them. Yeah, that's why I said.
So you have a visual, right?
Yes, they'll have the same visual. It'll just be a 20-second delay. Hi, I'm Michi. It'll be a 20-second delay from what we have. Hi, everybody. Okay, so I see who's in the house now. Amishri, Lisha, Christine, Deanna, Aunt Elsie, Auntie Jackie, Judy, Sherianne. Hi, everybody. Holly, Uncle John, Janae, Lorraine, Stasia. Oh, that's Auntie Stella. Deandra, Tyree.
Go to the email, right?
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Okay, you know.
Hi.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
Hi, Alexis, everybody.
Hi. Hi. Okay. All right, so we'll get that set up.
Pull it up over there.
Okay, well, I have to see. Okay.
She's doing a live on the 7th. Mm-hmm. Okay. 18 people.
No, can you hear
everything?
Oh, I can't hear anything.
Let's see.
What's the account name?
Oh, just a minute.
Okay, no, go back on your YouTube so I can see.
We are looking crazy. Look at my hair. How is everybody doing with this pandemic?
Coping. Yeah. Hanging in
there.
Day
by day, right? I haven't left my house at all. I get anxiety when I go out. I can't. I haven't been able to leave.
Hanging in there.
Day by day, right? I haven't left my house at all.
Alexis, hi.
I get anxiety when I go out. I can't. Alexis, it's she stepped away for me. I haven't left my house either.
I don't want to say it in the
I'm hearing Desmond's voice.
Desmond didn't go to New York. I think he's still in Georgia.
Yeah, but I'm hearing
Desmond's voice.
He didn't. He might be signed in, but he didn't come.
Desmond didn't go to New York. I think he's still in Georgia.
Yeah,
but I'm hearing Desmond's voice.
Is Dawn down here?
Yeah, my dad's on there.
Is Dawn down
here?
Yeah, my dad's on there. You found it?
Yeah, my dad's on there.
You have it or you found it?
Hey guys, if you're not talking, I think it's wise to just mute your mic so it doesn't get feedback. It'll keep echoing all day.
un otro lado. All right, if everyone could mute their audio, please. I thought I had it already set to that.
You could actually do it and mute all.
Yeah, I was trying to find it and I can't.
You're so dark.
I know. Let me let's see. Let me. Okay. All right.
You got it?
I don't. That's strange. So I thought. Okay. Okay, I see.
And then there are going to be a lot of late joiners too.
Uh huh.
So.
Oh, I put it to where it doesn't alert us when people enter.
No, but you should also monitor it to mute them automatically.
Oh yeah, so I just mute all.
Okay.
I thought I had it to mute automatically, but I didn't. So that's okay. That's okay. Okay. Okay, so everyone's muted. Okay. Okay.
So,
yeah, he's signing in now. So it's 4:52.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So
we're just ahead of the schedule. I can see the link. And we're on YouTube
Live. So everybody is just signing
in. Are you going
to
use
your
phone? Yeah, I'm going to use it instead of this.
So
you're
just
going to
leave that up?
Let's see. Gonna put on my big coat.
Got another jacket if you need it.
Yeah, I'll pull it up.
Alexi, do you want to bring the tripod closer?
With this? Oh, yeah, we're going to have to put it on. I'm just going to put it on.
Oh, okay.
Stand like that way so that the people here can see under. Are you taking
the what you're saying? Yes, so we're going to use this.
Okay.
It's just we have that signed in already.
Oh,
so we we'll use this and we can have it closer.
I'll go and just hold it. I'll make sure
that's different. Okay. Oh, then we'll do it right here.
Recognize you with your mask here. Take it easy.
Hi, everyone. I know we can't keep our mics on, but you guys can look at this, the toolbar at the bottom. There's a chat room. We can type to each other if you guys want.
Well,
Okay, so this is a nice clear view for everybody. Everybody see well? Should be good. Remember to mute your cameras. We got a closer view. Okay, I can see your messages.
That way everybody can see. Just see. All right here.
Yeah.
Can people see?
Just a quick note, everyone, if you want to see the gravesite as the main view, look at Lexi's image up to the top right and click on pin view and it'll expand to the whole screen.
Thank you, Lorraine.
I don't get that option.
You need to hover over Lexi's image on the top right. There'll be three dots. Then hover over those dots. You will see pin view and click on that.
Okay, now I see what the delay is.
But on YouTube, it delays by 20 seconds. So the people that are watching in YouTube, they have a 20-second delay. So we're giving people time to arrive, if they're signing in late. So we'll begin around 1:05. Again, I just ask that everybody please mute your audio.
Hi, Lexi.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, Lexi.
Hi. Hi to us. We're about to begin, so I'm. If everyone could please mute your speakers, please.
She wants me to mute the speaker.
Thank you, everyone. We'll begin in a few moments. Just hang tight. Thank you.
works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to his side. With love and strength for each new day, he will make a way.
Yeah.
Hi, good afternoon, everybody. Everyone, how are you all doing? Can you hear me? Give me a thumbs up or something if you can hear me.
Yes, okay, great.
Do I? All right. Praise God. Let me see if I can have some light on my side. 1 second. Alexi, how are you doing there? I just want to, first of all, good afternoon to everyone. And we're coming together, you know, at this time to celebrate the life of Emery Robain, Auntie Anne, Granny. This is not something that we may have planned, but it's something that happened. And I know that we have family, friends, and well-wishers all over the world right now. And the fact that it's very difficult for us to meet, but I thank God that we're able to meet online, meet on YouTube, just to pay our respect, because I know that Auntie Anne is a significant person in our lives and has touched us in one way or the other. I know we have family in Trinidad. We have probably have family in Florida. We have family in New Jersey. I see Christine in New Jersey. I see Ruth at work. I see Derek and Alexis and they at the burial ground, and there are other people who are looking right now. So I want to open with a little prayer. Can everybody hear me? Yes? Okay. I see Lorraine in the Bronx. I see Miss Elsie Rosado, Jackie, Calvin, Listra, Walters, Blessings, Stacy is there. Okay. So let us get into a little prayer. You know, You know, sometimes in situations and circumstances like these, you really don't know what to say, but we have to trust God to give us the strength. Father, we come to you right now in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You're the sovereign God and all things are in your hands. We come today, Lord God, for a moment of respect, a moment of homegoing. Lord, we do not understand everything, and some of the things that we face at times can be too much, but we know that you are God who makes the way. So as we come together, we're asking for your comfort. We're asking for your strength. We're asking, Lord God, that your peace flow in our lives like a river. For Lord God, your word says, come to me, all those who labor, those who are overburdened, I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I'm meek and gentle of heart, and you'll find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. And Lord God, we're lifting up our families, we're lifting up our friends, we're lifting up your people tonight. We're lifting up Derek and Desmond and Dawn and Darren and all the grand and all the brothers and sisters, David and all the family members and the nieces and nephews right now, that you give us strength, that you give us peace to flow in our lives like a river. Spirit of the living God, we ask that you just touch our hearts right now, even in areas of brokenness, even in areas of uncertainty, you know, not knowing what is happening and what is going on all around us. And we cry out to a God who's a God who's able to save. And so we thank you, Lord God. We thank you for life. We thank you for this moment when we can come together and we can unite as a family, one people under you right now for a circumstance, a situation that may not be pleasant and we do not have all the answers for, but Lord, we trust in you. Lord, your word says, for those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They will mount up with wings like eagle. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and they shall not faint. And so, Father, we ask that you hold us up, that we may not faint, that as we run, we will not be weary, as we combat conditions and situations and afflictions, Lord God, and uncertainty and pressures, Lord God, that we would know in the midst of it that you are our strength, you are our shield, and you are our song. Lord, we know that absent from the body with a relationship with you is present with the Lord. And Lord, we celebrate the life of Anne Marie, your daughter. We give you thanks and give you praise for the many memories and for the love that she sowed and for the kindness, Lord God, and the ups and downs, even in her life. We give you thanks and we give you praise, Lord God, that you have granted her even so long life. But we pray, Lord God, for a blessing even in this situation. And as we bid her farewell, but yet we pray a homecoming for her, that she would rejoice even with family members who would be with you, that Lord God, that you would give us comfort in this. So we give you all glory, give you all honor, and we give you all praise. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. This is a little bit unusual, but I wanted to just give a word of encouragement to everyone present. And I know that it may be the first time in our lives that we have to meet in such a way, but the good side of it is that we're able to meet. And we couldn't meet unless there was a spirit of love that could unify us. And I believe that Auntie Anne, you know, and our family, the Rubains and all the other families, the Clarences, and, you know, It is something that over the years that was sown, you know, that now we see that at a departure, even though there's so much restrictions in terms of having a burial, that you and me and everyone can still come together and say, I want to be here for this moment because Anne Marie was special to me. Anne Marie touched my life. So, you know, in these circumstances, I know we have Desmond and Donald and Darren. I'm not sure if they're present. I don't think they are, but they are very dear to the family. And we want to send our love as we're on Zoom here, as we're on YouTube. We want to send our love out to them and Auntie Anne's brothers and sisters and nieces and nephews and all the family members. We want you all to know that we are together in this and that we're holding one another because of the love of God. We are encouraging one another. It is not an easy thing to bear, to suffer the loss of anyone, especially under the crisis that the world is seeing right now. But there is a light, even in a dark situation, even under a dark cloud, there is a light. A light is shining, and that light comes from the love that flows from within us, the love that God has placed in our hearts, that we can stop and take time out to say, you understand, I'm here for you. You know, we reach out to one another with words of encouragement to say that we can get through this. We can get through this storm. It's another storm, you know, in life. And I remembered it was about 2 years ago when our beloved Denise went on to be with the Lord, and it was something that was a shock and was hard to even go through it. But in all of it, God gave us the strength, and I just, you know, even to pray for Lexi, who is also behind the scenes trying to make everything happen and to make this home going. I know Granny was very special to her also. And so I just pray that God will give her the strength. But what I want to encourage you understand, is to keep trusting God, even though things don't look right and things may not be going right. You know, there are many who have been afflicted, some recovered, some close friends of us and families have not recovered during this pandemic, during, you know, this time. But our hope and our trust is in God. As the scripture says in Isaiah 40:31, those who wait on the Lord, they will renew their strength. It may be a time of quarantine for many of us, but while we're in quarantine, we are trusting God that this too will pass. We're trusting God that he will bring comfort, healing, and strength. We are trusting God that he will transform. And in all of this, there will be some good, some great lesson to learn in all of this. And so we see right now, one good positive thing is that we have people who care, people of compassion, people of love right now who are unifying to say, we are one. We are one family. And so we thank God for this. I'm not sure because right now we're just kind of like winging it. I haven't heard Lexi's voice in a minute. I'm not sure how the reception is over there, but I'm just going to, for a moment, open the lines. You may have words of encouragement to share. You may have something that you want to say. I know, you know, it's hard, but I know that Auntie Anne, you know, has been special to a lot of us. So I'm going to leave it open.
Hello.
Hi.
Are you all hearing me well?
Yeah.
Okay. So I want to read the eulogy.
and then we'll open it up if other people would like to speak. Is that okay? This is Lexi, by the way. All right. Anne Marie Thelma Robain, 83, was called to be with the Lord on Wednesday, April 8th, 2020. Anne Marie was born in Balmain Village, Cuba, Trinidad, on Monday, November 16th, 1936, the eldest daughter to David and Maggie Clarence. She attended Balmain Presbyterian School in Balmain Village, Cuba, Trinidad. Anne Marie began her first job as a cashier at Ming Sing Supermarket in Trinidad, where she met her husband, Leo Robain. Anne Marie would frequently visit the store. Leo would frequently visit the store to ask Anne Marie on a date. And after a while, she finally gave in. Their love blossomed and they married in 1958. They started their family in Maracas Valley, Trinidad, where they had five children. Leo migrated to the United States of America, followed by Anne Marie in 1973 and the children in 1974, where they began.
The sound went off.
Okay, just bear with Sassia for a moment. It might be a reception problem, or she may just need to compose herself for a moment. Okay, thanks.
Lexi, want to use the laptop?
Technology. Thank you for your patience, everyone.
Got it.
Can you hear me? I think it's just the car turned off. If somebody could turn the car back on, that'll be good so we can hear. The key is here.
We can hear you.
Okay, thank you. Leo migrated to the United States of America, followed by Anne Marie in 1973 and the children in 1974, where they began their life. And in 1977, they purchased their house in Baltimore. Anne Marie was an intelligent woman, at one point studying teaching and also attending commercial school to obtain a post-secondary education in office administration. Her first job in the States was at the F.W. Woolworth Company, and she later moved on to Merrill Lynch in Manhattan, New York. While working and taking care of her home, Anne Marie also found time to harness her entrepreneurial spirit by capitalizing on her culinary gifts. She began fulfilling orders for roti, black cake, and her infamous pastel. She held her job at the Federal Reserve Bank of New York for more than a decade, where she retired shortly after the turn of the 21st century. Within 5 years of retirement, Anne Marie fulfilled one of her dreams and began the groundwork on her house in Maracas Valley, Trinidad. Anne Marie would frequently visit her home for months at a time. She loved to eat the fresh mangoes and watch the waterfall from the gallery while catching a cool breeze. Anne Marie was an adventurous woman who loved to travel around the world and gain new experiences. Places she journeyed to included, but were not limited to, Antigua, Australia, Hawaii, Jamaica, London, Martinique, Paris, Puerto Rico, Rome, St. Kitts, St. Thomas, and Tobago.
She also loved to travel to New Orleans, Louisiana, where she appreciated the authentic culture and gumbo. She loved the gumbo. Anne Marie loved a good laugh and well-seasoned food. She also loved to dress, which she did very well. Anne Marie enjoyed listening to her calypso most days, but every day was a day to discuss politics. Her passion for whom and what she loved was astonishing. Anne Marie was a genuinely good person with so much love to give. She made sure each person she encountered experienced that unconditional love no matter the occasion. She opened her home to many family members and friends, whether it was for a short or long-term stay, or even for one of the many parties she hosted. No matter the reason, not a soul would leave her home without a full stomach and the overwhelming feeling of love. She would give her very last just to see someone smile. Anne Marie is preceded in death by her beloved husband, Leo Robain, 1999, father, David Clarence, 1984, mother, Maggie Clarence, 2002, her brothers, John Clarence, 1966, and Russell Clarence, her daughter, Denise Robain, 2000. And stepdaughter, Anne Marie Madu, 1998. Anne Marie is survived by her sons, wives, Derek, Marlene, Desmond, Sandra, Donald, Vanette, and Darren. She also leaves her love to her siblings and spouses, Wilfred, Dick, Clarence, wife Roselle, Winston Griffith, Pearl, Rosabelle, Rose, Dylan, Arthur Seymour Clarence, Jonathan David Clarence, Claudia Joan, Stella Clarence, Gloria Paris, Jude, and Patricia Blackett, Dowlin, Darwin. Anne Marie is also survived by her grandchildren, Candace, Alexis, Deanna, Deandra, Stasia, Deshaun, Natalia, which is her great-granddaughter, Kayla, and Vincent. Anne Marie also leaves her loving memories to be cherished by nearly 45 loved ones, including nieces, nephews, great-nieces, and great-nephews. She was also survived by her cousins, Gordon Guerra, Myrtle Lee, Pearl Henderson, Gloria Nelson, Stella John, Annette Alcantara, Joyce Giles, and many others. Anne Marie genuinely cherished her relationships with all of her family and friends. Anne Marie touched so many people with her nurturing spirit, and she accomplished so much in her lifetime. She was able to fulfill her ultimate goal at a small church in Powder Springs, Georgia, where she rededicated her life to her Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. May the joy and love that Anne Marie brought to your heart be passed on through you to others. Through this, her legacy may live on forever. Rest in peace, Grandma. So now we can open it up if anyone would like to say something nice about Grandma. Our cousin Gloria will speak first, and then Deanna, and then we'll open it up to others. Everyone, please keep your microphones muted while others are speaking. Thank you.
Distinct honor.
Yeah, ask if they can hear you.
Can everyone hear me?
Okay, good.
Good, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. It is with distinct honor as we celebrate the life of my dear cousin, Anne-Marie Rubain, that I speak on behalf of my sisters, my brother, and all of our cousins, the Guerra family and the Clarence family. Anne-Marie was actually the eldest of all of our cousins and the oldest daughter of Maggie and David Clarence and the eldest granddaughter of the Clarences. And so she was really very special. And if you look in the collage that was sent to the family members, you would see that there was a picture of her actually 5 years old, which is actually over 70 something years old that we captured and actually framed her for her. I did a few years ago. And she was a flower girl in my mother's wedding. So that's how well she was celebrated and cherished as a young girl. She was a wonderful woman of God, and every area of her life that God see fit to allow her to walk in as mother, grandmother, sister, cousins, every relationship she entrusted and poured into us. She was actually not only cousins to my sister Myrtle, but very close friend and confidant of my sister Myrtle and my cousin Joyce and many others of the older cousins. They remained very close even to the end. My sister Myrtle, every time she would visit Trinidad, which is actually became every year, she had to not take a flight from Boston, but she had to drive to New York, spend either a day or two with Anne-Marie, and then took a flight from New York to Trinidad. I asked her, why would you even go through that? And she told me, just leave it alone, that was their thing. Okay, so they had a lot of cherished times together. As myself, one of the most amazing memory that I have of Anne-Marie was on her 80th birthday, she at her daughter Denise's house where we celebrated her 80th birthday. And Denise came out with this beautiful cake, well lit, and she sat on the sofa with the cake in the middle and Anne-Marie on one side and Denise in the middle. And we could just see her face lit up as we sang happy birthday to her. We were able to capture that moment on camera and gave it to her later on. I think it was the year after Denise died. And she shared with me sometime later that she had the picture on her dresser. She would look at it every day and just smile at that time and that moment. She was a person, and it didn't matter how small the gesture was that you would give to her, whether it was a small picture that we downloaded and actually took that picture from Walmart and framed it, which was more than likely under $15, probably $10, that she cherished it like if it was $1 million. And that was just the type of person she was. She was an amazing person that loved politics, and she always was excited to have a good conversation around politics. Another memory I had of her when she heard that my mom was about to pass away, she would get with Derek. Derek had to drive her anywhere she wanted to go. So I know Derek is going to miss those moments because she heard my mother was sick. Derek had to drive her from New York to Boston so she can spend a day with my mom. My mother died within a week of that time that she spent with my mom. She drove back to Boston for my mom's funeral. When I got consecrated as a bishop, Derek had to drive her back to Boston, my consecration with her three sisters and Derek, and she could not miss that moment. Well, one of the moments that I cherish, and I'm glad that I did that, is that we had to have a representation of our family. Usually it's your mother or your father or someone close to represent me as I went forth with my bishopric on that day. And I chose Anne-Marie as one of the people that would represent our family. She was so honored to represent me on that day, and I will never, ever forget that. The look of pride on her face, the tears that she shed during my ceremony, and just the love that she gave to us all, not only as family, but we can commemorate her as friends, as confidant, and many other areas in our life. I'm gonna leave in my closing. I am mindful of the scripture coming from the Gospel of St. John, that Jesus himself spoke, St. John chapter 14, 1-3. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Today we take comfort that Anne-Marie is with the Lord. She had a heart of gold. She had a forgiving heart. She had a heart that cherished many others. We know that Anne-Marie fought a good fight. She finished her course. She kept the faith. And now set up for her a crown of righteousness. Amen. And so today, I say to her sons and to her grandchildren and her granddaughter, Lexi, and her sisters and to her brothers, that allow her legacy of love to go forward and live within your heart. Cherish those good memories. Amen. The good memories that you had for her. I know that they were many. And we know that we love her, but we have to release her to the Lord because God loves her best. The Lord gives and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Rest well, my dear cousin. Rest well. Amen. God bless each and every one of you.
Yeah.
All right, if you're not, next up we'll have Deanna. And anyone who's not speaking, please mute your microphone.
Okay. Can everybody hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. Thank you guys for coming. I know it's a really difficult time, and this is kind of a weird, confusing time for everyone right now, and so I'm just really glad, you know, and grateful and thankful we get to have something like a platform like this to come and pay respect to my grandmother. You know, it's just trying to put away, you know, anger aside and the politics and things like that. Because yeah, it's extremely confusing what's going on right now. But yeah, my grandma was just, yeah, she's awesome, loving person. Love to cook. Oh my gosh. Love to cook. Have the most amazing cuisine. We missed out on that for a good 17 years or so after we moved to Arizona. Our family relocated to Arizona when I was about 8. So I thank God that we at least, you know, had time to establish that relationship early on with her. I had many times, since I was the eldest of our family, many times to go over to grandma's house and chill and play with my cousins. And so, you know, I'm just sending comfort to the whole family during this time, because I know it's difficult. And then I just want to share, you know, my recent memories with her. So the first time I saw her after moving was, I believe, actually in Trinidad. We went to go try to see her in New York, which we were in 2016, but she was actually in Trinidad, so we missed her. But I did go to visit early 2017 to Trinidad for the first time with all the girl cousins, minus my sister. So we stayed at her house, and of course she was extremely, extremely loving. Like, there was no doubt, like, I was going to be taken care of by my uncles and cousins, everyone there. So it was really awesome. And visited her after my other grandfather passed away in New York. She got to see all of her grandchildren, her son Don. And I was really grateful for that, that my brothers got to at least, you know, see her. And then Atlanta, I got to go and visit her and Lexi in Atlanta for the first time last year for Thanksgiving, and I just thank the Most High for that moment. That, like Lexi said, that trip was really needed for us. Just the time to bond, the time to, you know, get to know each other a little bit more, and taste her cooking one last time for me. And I just wanted to mention, like, you know, I'm just so glad. I'm really sad. This is a sad time right now for all of us, but I'm just so thankful that she's not in pain anymore, because to see her recently and you know, just the condition she was in, like, she couldn't get out of bed sometimes. It was really difficult to see her like that. So she's not in the
body anymore, and I know I'm trying to focus more on the spiritual aspects of life. So I know that we come from the ether, so we return to the ether. We are all energetic beings, so she, you know, we have to realize, you know, her essence, her spirit is still with us. Energy never dissipates, it never dies. So that's what gives me comfort. I know that she's with us always. And same with Aunt Denise and Grandpa Leo. Right now, you know, we're just taking it one step at a time. And, you know, it really does get better over time and knowledge. And the last time I talked to her was probably about a month before she passed. And I was actually, this was before the coronavirus stuff started to really go off. Actually, probably the first few weeks, I took a trip to New Orleans with my friend, and I called her to see how she was doing, and then she just explained how she loved New Orleans and the food. I don't really eat seafood, but I was just hoping one day that I would actually, you know, get to visit with her, possibly, but it is what it is. But again, I'm glad she's not in pain, and just sending all my love out to family members and just hoping that we all reach out to each other and just strengthen our bodies and our spirits and stay strong, especially during these testing times. The Most High is definitely in control right now, so we just have to leave it in His hands. That's it. Love you, Grandma, forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Deanna. Thank you so much. So now we're going to all, you know, walk up to Grandma's casket and lay our roses. And then we'll conclude the service. Uncle Johnny, if you're there, if you could play your background music, that would be wonderful.
Oh.
Thank you so much. And everyone else, if you could mute your microphones, please.
We close. I just want to share 15 seconds with Auntie Anne. Can I?
Last time I ate that oolong, well, that was to die for.
It was good.
Oh yeah. My goodness, that oolong was good.
Sharing a video of Grandma. So nice.
Last time I ate that oolong, it was well confident.
Yeah,
that was 58 good days.
Yes.
And it's somewhat that oolong was good. After that, I eat the roti.
That was beautiful.
You know, Denise was my best friend. And sometimes we didn't even talk, we just cried. Part of this. She will always be in my heart. Bye.
One else, love you.
Thank you.
And anyone before we close out?
And Ruth, you take care of yourself, baby. Stay safe.
Okay, thank you, baby. I haven't seen you in so long.
I know, my darling, I know.
You look good.
But
you look good.
Your face.
I know.
Bye.
Thank you, baby. Okay, so I'm going to share a little memory that I had. Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so listen. I used to go on weekends to spend time with Denise. We go to the clubs, Red Parrot, and all these nice clubs we used to go to. And on a Sunday morning when we got up, first thing me and Dini's fighting for is the pigtail in the callaloo. She made the best callaloo ever. And when me and Dini's go downstairs, Dini's is like, that piece of pigtail is mine. And I said, Dini's, I am the guest here. I'm supposed to have first pick at the pigtail. So listen, that was one of the best memories. Auntie Anne said, I put enough pigtail for both of you guys to share. Stop fighting for the pigtail. She used to make the best pigtail callaloo. And my memory is going up there every weekend. She's like, you guys going out tonight again? You guys ain't tired? So it was, and listen, I have good, good memories. And Alexi?
I think she left.
I'm still here.
Oh, Lexi, my condolences, yeah. Baby.
Thank you.
I don't think she's hearing me.
Thank you, Auntie. I hear you.
Okay, you're welcome, baby. Take care of yourself.
Nobody else is going to talk. I'm going to leave the meeting.
Okay, thank you, everybody, for your attendance, your love, and your prayers.
Thank you.
You're welcome, baby.
Hi. All right. Hi, good day.
Alexi.
Hi, Alex. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Yes.
I am Joyce from Trinidad, aunt's cousin.
Hi. Oh. Hi, Joyce.
Yes, I am. I am happy that I visited her in August. That's the last time I spoke to her. We laughed, we talk about politics, and most of all about her daughter, Denise. You know, she couldn't forget her at all. All her talk was on Denise. My condolences to all her son, Derek, and the rest of them, even though Darren down here, all her brothers and sisters and Stella. I felt so sad. I spoke to her about a week before she died. And I know she was well sick when she spoke to me. And so I told Myrtle and the rest of them. I really miss her, especially when she comes to Trinidad. I always visited her in Americas. She loved Koruma and I make Kuchila, and I always took it for her. I really miss her, you know? And may she rest in it. But she have eternal rest, and I know she's in a better place. No,
amen.
Thank you. Everyone is done. I'd like to
close us off in a word of prayer, please.
Thank you.
Amen. All hearts Amen. And mind cleared. Father, we thank you and we bless your name as we come to a closure of the celebration of life of Anne-Marie Rubain. Lord God, she meant so much to us. And Lord God, you said the Lord give and the Lord take it away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those that believe in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And I know that she lives in eternal life. Lord, we ask a special blessing upon the entire family, upon her children, her sons, her granddaughters, her grandchildren, all of them. We pray that you would anoint us with oil and strengthen us as we press on, Lord God, towards the prize of the mark of the higher calling. Strengthen us in Jesus' name as we look to the hills from whence cometh our help, for all our help cometh from the Lord, which makes heaven and earth. Amen and amen. May the Lord bless your soul.
Amen. Thank you. Goodbye.
Amen. Bye-bye.
Amen. Blessings God bless everyone. Each and every one of you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. God Amen. Bless us.
Same Bye. To all. Lexi?
Yes.
We can sign off now.
Yes, I'll be sharing a link with everyone later of a I'll be sharing a link of a
Okay.
Thank you.
Send it to me, okay, Alexi?
Thank you.
Thank you, Lexi.
Nobody's answering. I think they're closed. I tried three times already. Let me try one more time. People are here. Nobody answering. You want to try back tomorrow? Okay. I'll call all day today and try to get it. Come tomorrow. First.